So, I'll admit, I'm not the biggest Carolina Hurricanes fan, and the majority of the stuff that I see about this team usually comes in the form of updates and tweets and subreddit posts and all that stuff. I'm not actively going out there and watching too many Hurricanes games. Sure, they have a great record, 2-0. Very good start to the NHL season so far, and if you take a look at the games they have won, hey, 6-3 over the Isles in Game 1, 3-2 over the Predators in Game 2, very convincing wins right there. But when I saw this post pop up on the Montreal Canadiens subreddit, it kind of got me digging a little bit as to what exactly the Hurricanes are doing with one player in particular, because this meme has been thrown around a lot over the past... When the heck was the Stanley Cup playoffs? Montreal versus Toronto, June? No, was it earlier than that? Yeah, the past few months. It's a meme, and it involves Carolina Hurricanes forward Jesperi Kotkaniemi. Hey, KK, which line did you get moved to after only a few periods in Carolina? And then he has the 4 going up over there. It's at 600-plus upvotes at the time of recording this audio, and all the comments just kind of go over the same thing. Pretty much just memeing the situation, saying the same things. Okay, if Carolina does really well with Kotkaniemi, I'm going to be pissed off. At least the team is 2-0, so I don't really think that KK cares all too much. He's making a whole bunch of money to being played on the fourth line. It's not that bad. In fact, if you compare situations of the teams, there are some Canadiens fans that say, yeah, well, at least they're 2-0. We're 0-3, and we suck. At the very end of the day, Jesperi Kotkaniemi getting played however many minutes is not that bad. But I just wanted to go over the optics of the situation, you know? Not just how he has played or how he has been used, but what this looks like. Because those two things can be very different things. Well, I guess those are three things that I listed. The first two things and the last thing could be very different things. Carolina Hurricanes fans could be very happy with Kotkaniemi, but from a surface level point of view, I just wanted to go over some numbers over here. Just in case anyone was wondering what Kotkaniemi did last night, this tweet is from the 17th, it's talking about the game against the Predators on the 16th, Kotkaniemi was second last on the Canes in average time on ice. He was also playing less than what he did with the Canadiens, if anybody was wondering. There also was this tweet that I wanted to highlight over here. Kotkaniemi is going to be a solid NHLer. It just may not happen this season. Carolina's $6 million winger played 12 minutes and 9 seconds last night, and he had the 8th most power play time amongst Carolina forwards. Here's hoping there are Dundon tears on KK's bi-monthly checks. Now, I'm not going to go out there and highlight only the negative because guess what? Earlier in the week, after those two games, they actually reunited the Finns onto a line over here, and dailyfaceoff.com has KK listed as a first-line left winger with Sebastian Aho and Toivo Teravainen. So, if you want to take the bad with the good or the good with the bad, I guess, there's your dichotomy in that situation right there. But just taking a look at the optics of the first two games and how Kotkaniemi has been deployed, there's a reason why this meme kind of went popular on the Canadian subreddit. Firstly, because it's funny. Secondly, because having Kotkaniemi as a fourth line player kind of goes out there and, I don't want to say confirms, but it kind of validates some of the concerns that Montreal Canadiens fans had about this guy. And it makes things even more easier to bear, I guess. If you're a big Kotkaniemi fan, it's a lot easier to look at this and say, okay, well, I'm kind of happy that he's not on our team then, because if he's a fourth-line player on Carolina, he's getting played the least amongst active forwards, or whatever it was, second least amongst players in the lineup that are forwards. Just imagine what it would have been like having this kind of player on the Montreal Canadiens, who is honestly, according to some of the people that had been watching all these Carolina games, been playing a little bit the same as he did in Montreal. At $6 million. Had the Canadiens matched this Kotkaniemi offer sheet, they did not acquire Christian Dvorak, and guess what? He plays in Montreal the same way he played last season, with no significant improvements. And he's getting paid $6 million on top of that, it would have been absolute hellfire in Montreal had Kotkaniemi stuck around and had he been played the same way. Now that he's in Carolina, it's a lot easier to observe that situation from a third-party standpoint. You're not involved in this story anymore, Montreal. You're not involved in the development of this guy, and you're not, frankly, a fan of the Carolina Hurricanes. You're a fan of the Canadiens. So anybody who is a Habs fan looking at this from the outside, it becomes a lot easier to say, okay, he's getting played 12 minutes a night. He's getting played second least amongst active forwards. He's on the second power play, and the second power play in Carolina barely even plays. And he's making $6 million a season. This is Tom Dundon going out there and really just laying the smackdown on his own hockey team, saying, yeah, you know, my petty revenge is good enough to the point that we can go out there and pay a 12-minute player $6+ million a year. I've said it this entire time, and I'll have to say it one more time, because Carolina Hurricanes fans, I love you guys, but I have to say this for a reason. I think Kotkaniemi can become a good player. He was drafted third overall for a reason. I was very high on him back at the 2018 NHL Entry Draft. You can even see the video that I made on my channel talking about how I wanted this guy for the Vancouver Canucks, and I would have been okay with him at seventh overall. But still, is he a $6 million player right now? No. Is he going to be a $6 million player next year? Probably not. Give him a few years and then decide whether or not he is at that caliber. It's just this overpayment of an offer sheet was very clearly motivated by other means, not because they wanted to pay Kotkaniemi $6 million because they thought he was a good player that was worth that money. It's just they wanted to trade for this guy, it didn't work out, and then, you know, revenge. They said it wasn't for revenge, but come on. The Twitter account, the memes, it's for revenge. Another interesting part about the optics of this, that's kind of what we're just talking about here if you hadn't realized already, how this looks. This Canadiens meme that was posted on the subreddit, you know, the fourth line thing, which line did you get moved to after only a few periods in Carolina, this was screenshotted and posted onto the Carolina Hurricanes subreddit. And as you can probably tell, the response on that community is not all too great either. A lot of the comments are saying, okay, I can't wait till Thursday, boy. Thursday! Let's go till Thursday! Bring it up then! We need to wait till then because the Carolina Hurricanes actually had a very big break. Their last game was on the 16th on Saturday, and Thursday is their very next game where they'll be visiting the Montreal Canadiens. And yeah, KK's gonna be in that building, full capacity, whatever, whatever, Canadiens fans gonna be there. You know they're gonna start booing this guy every time he touches the puck. And quite frankly, I'm not gonna say it's unfair. He did sign an offer sheet with another team that put his own hockey team at the time in a very precarious spot where they needed to make a difficult decision. But at the end of the day as well, like, you can't blame the guy that he was a vehicle for the Carolina Hurricanes' own petty revenge. He was just an object in this entire situation. He was the means to an end to getting a message across that the Carolina Hurricanes wanted to send to the Habs, and that in itself is not his fault. He had no choice over that. They were like, okay, here, $6 million. Take this. Sign with us. Come to our team. You have Finnish friends here. So I don't blame him, again. Definitely don't want to say that Kotkaniemi is an evil person for accepting an offer sheet that was vastly overpaying of his services. It's just kind of funny, you know? Optics. Again, it's how it looks on the outside. For the Carolina Hurricanes, they could be using this guy as appropriately as they see fit, and they could be having zero problems with his development. He's getting played in the first line now with Aho and Teräväinen, and in fact, if they keep that first line together for Montreal on Thursday, then I think things are going to get very spicy when Kotkaniemi scores his first goal of the NHL season against Montreal in the Bell Center. Oh, baby! That's what I'm talking about. Optics right there. The conversation gets a lot more interesting when Kotkaniemi goes out there and he does his damage against the Habs in the Habs home court. Talk to me in the comments, what do you think about the Canadiens' former third overall pick and the way he has started his season? Sure, he hasn't been played much. Sure, he's been put on the fourth line. But that may change as soon as Thursday when the Carolina Hurricanes suit up in the Bell Center in Montreal against KK's former team. Let me know your thoughts about the situation in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this Vidishar Ashrolls 9 and bye.